Yes, hello. Before today, we have become acquainted with the cells like tissue like parenchyma, colenchyma, and sclerenchyma. They have function as the mechanical tissue. But their structure is quite simple, and hence they are also termed as the simple tissue. So the second group of tissue are the xylem and phloem, that are conducting tissue, and functionally their function is to conduct water and distribute in the every tissue and cells of the plant, and phloem for conduction of food material that is synthesized in the leaves. But their structure is quite complex, and hence they are termed as complex tissue. So now today we shall read the nature of the xylem tissue and phloem tissue. The xylem is not a single tissue, but it is the group of elements. That is the xylem tracheids, xylem vessel, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fiber. So we will read them one by one. The first is tracheid. The tracheids are like the tube-like structures and chiefly responsible for the conduction of water. They have pits, and their cells are lignified and without the protoplast. At maturity, they become non-living. There is the connection from one cylinder to the other cylinder, and in the separating wall, there are various types of perforations. They are of different shapes, like they may be annular, they may be a spiral, they may be a scalary form. The tracheids are found in all vascular plants, and in that pteridophytes, there are some pits in it, and the pit is a certain type of perforations, and they are called as the border pits. In we know that there are two types of xylems, protoxylem and second the metaxylem. In the protoxylem, the tracheids has a spiral and annular thickening, whereas in the metaxylem they have border pits and a scalary form. A scalary form means like the ladder thickenings. In between the two cells, on the separating wall, cylindrical structures, there are separating wall, and there are certain pores, and these pores have certain membrane that is known as the pit membrane, and the pore in gymnosperm is known as the torus. So this membrane is responsible for the opening and closing of the tracheids. The opening and the closing of the tracheids are dependent on the movement of the pit membrane. So in the lower vascular plants like pteridophytes and gymnosperms, tracheid is the main xylem unit for the conduction of water. As the vessels are not found in these lower vascular plants, so this is the chief character of the tracheids. And the second are xylem vessels. Vessels are found in higher gymnosperm, evolved gymnosperm, that is neatum and the angiosperm. In the neatum, it is known as the neatum is the forerunner of the angiospermic plants. So in neatum as well as in angiosperms, vessels are found. Vessels are the cylindrical structure just fitted like the pipe one above the another, and in between them there are perforated plates. So the plates are perforated, and in the walls and in the separating walls there are pit like structures, and through which the water absorbed is conducted from one cell to the another. So the vessels have also thickenings, and they are of annular type, spiral types, scalary form types, and different type, reticulate type. When they are net-like structure, they are called reticulate. So there are different type of thickenings in between them, and the nature of the vessel, the vessel is found in the higher angiospermic plant. In the primitive angiospermic plants like Dremis, Degeneria, Yucca, Dracaena, these are the primitive angiospermic plants, they are not found. So they are in entire angiospermic plants, except some vessels are found. And in gymnosperm, it is found only in neatum. The third is xylem parenchyma. They are the parenchymatous cells having different type of cells. They may be rectangular, they may be oval, and of different shapes, but their wall is primarily, they are made up of, the wall is of cellulose nature, but later on they become lignified. So when the plant have secondary growth, they are crushed in between the secondary xylem, and the cells of the xylem parenchyma become sclerotic, and gradually they diminishes. And here these are the cells that are of two kinds. One is the xylem parenchyma, and second is the xylem ray, and they are also known, the ray parenchyma is also known as the medullary ray. So this is the third element of xylem. The next is the xylem fiber. These are lignified cells, and their chief function is to give a strength to the xylem elements, because if they collapse, there is no conduction of water, so these fibers give them mechanical strength, so they become erect and stout, and the conduction of water is not interrupted, and they have tapering ends, and in some there may be found that their lumen is narrow and they have pits also. So actually they are formed from the tracheids. The tracheids get metamorphosed to form xylem fibers. The xylem fibers are the mechanical tissue, and they give mechanical strength to the xylem vessels, xylem elements. So these are the chief elements of xylem. The next is phloem. As we know, phloem is responsible for the conduction of synthesized food materials from the leaf, and it distributes throughout the plant body. So likewise, the xylem, it is also made up of phloem elements. The first is the sieve elements. The sieve elements is actually in the lower vascular plants, the sieve tube is not found. It, on place of the sieve tube, there are certain cell-like structure that are known as sieve cells, and they are also perforated. And in the higher vascular plants, in place of the sieve cells, there are tubular structures, and these tubular structures are known as sieve tube, and they have several thickenings in the sieve plate. The separating wall between the sieves is known as the sieve plate, and in the sieve plate there are certain reticulate or scalary form thickenings, and these thickenings are in the primary wall of the adjacent cells, and one cell with another cell is attached with connecting strands, and through them the conduction of solute material, synthesized food material takes place. And there are several pit-like structures also found in the adjacent, in the lateral wall of the adjacent sieve tubes, and through them that conduction of synthesized food material takes place. In the separating wall there is a chemical glue-like substance is found, that is the callus. The callus and cellulose are found, and in the spring season, usually they close the pits, and in the spring season, the callus is dissolved, and the conduction is rapidly, and hence the plant look robust. And so this is the chief character. In the lower form of vascular plants, in place of the sieve tube, there are sieve cells, and these sieve cells are attached with certain cells that are known as albuminous cells. The albuminous cell functions just like the cambium cell. The sieve cells, the sieve tube is always attached with the companion cell in the higher plants, as for example angiospermic plants, but the companion cells are not found in the lower vascular plants. The companion cell has a conspicuous nucleus and it is living, and the function of the companion cell is just to assist in the function of the sieve tube, and it gives support to the sieve tube also. Just in place of the companion cell in lower vascular plants, albuminous cells are found. The third element is the phloem parenchyma. As we know, it is primarily the cell wall is made up of cellulose, but later on lignified, and when the periderm is synthesized, is formed, then they diminishes the end. The phloem parenchyma lost their structure, and their function is to give assistance to the phloem elements. They are not found in the roots, so the phloem parenchyma are not found in the roots. The next is the phloem fibers. Just like the xylem fiber, the function of the phloem fiber is just to give a strength, mechanical strength, to the sieve elements and phloem elements, so that they can be able to conduct the synthesized food material, and they become strong and stout. Otherwise, they become collapsed, and they are found in, just like in the cortex, they are found, just like in the cortex the fibers are found, likewise the fibers are found in the phloem to give a strength. So this is the chief function of the phloem fiber. The phloem fibers of the plant body is of also economic importance. They are used for making of ropes, like in the hemp. Example is hemp. So these are the complex tissue, but their function is to conduct water or the synthesized food material. The third type of plant tissue are known as secretory tissue, as they secrete various types of excretory materials. In some, in some plant, they are like gland-like, and in other plant, they are like cells only. So, when they are in form of the cells, they synthesized excretory products and it is exuded outside the plant body, and hence in some cases the the excretory products get accumulated inside the cell, and when the cell brush they come out. The second is different type of glands, as for example digestive glands, nectaries, resin glands, resin producing glands, and latex production lactiferous cells. These all are included. They all form glands, and in the glands, latex lactiferous gland, they secrete latex. In resin gland, the resin is produced, and in some plants, like they are, these plants are known as hydathodes. These plant produce the water droplets come out through the edges of the leaf, and these are known as hydathodes. So these are not in form of vapors, but in form of water drops. So these are the hydathodes and the various type of glands. These are common glands found in the plant body. In the digestive glands are found as in Drosera. Nectaries are the nectar producing glands, and resin producing glands are found just in the pines. Lactiferous ducts are found in various plants like banana also, and hydathodes are found in colocasia. So different types of these secretory tissues are also found in the plant, and these are the different types of tissues found inside in the different forms of plants, as for as thus first is in some to summarize the tissue in the plants. There are two types of tissue. First are meristematic tissue, second are the permanent tissue. Meristematic tissue are of two kind: primary meristem, secondary meristem, and the permanent tissue are of three kinds. First, the simple permanent tissue, and the complex permanent tissue, and the third is the secretory permanent tissue. In the simple permanent tissue, parenchyma, colenchyma, and sclerenchyma, and in the complex tissue, there are xylem and phloem, and the third is the secretory tissue. So we have completed the tissue system, tissue in the plant. Now we will start the tissue system in the plant. Thank you.